All right, YouTube, welcome back. Today we're gonna be talking about the Reverb G2 V2. We're gonna compare it to the G2 V1 is what we're calling it, right? So same headset, they came out 1 year apart, and this one has several improvements, and we're gonna talk about those three major improvements today. So let's get into it, here we go. Now, a quick note, guys, this is not a full review. I already did a full review on the Reverb G2 headset, and that's already been up, so I'll leave that link below. I suggest you watch it at the end of this once you understand what the improvements are, and you can see all the things that I've learned throughout the past year with the Reverb G2 with my experience, right? And if it's your first time here, I want to say welcome to the channel. Thank you for watching. My name is Jose. I'm an air traffic controller. I'm a huge VR flight sim nerd and VR enthusiast. I've been flying in VR since 2014 with the Oculus DK1. I have the Quest 2. In fact, I have the Pimax 8KX sitting right here in a box, which I'm going to review for you guys a little bit later on, give you my ideas, give you a setup tutorial on that. But today we're here for the improvements on this headset. So let's do it. Now, real fast, I've had a lot of coffee, so bear with me and drink some if you have it. But as I look at my notes here, the Reverb G1 came out in June 2019, and I did own the G1. It was amazing. The Reverb G2 was released in November 2020, and we just got the G2 V2 1 year later in October 2021. Now, if you guys missed it, they were on sale for as low as $450, and that was a really, really good price for that headset. All right, guys, here. So for the specs, it's actually running two LCD panels at 2160 by 2160 resolution, which is a combined of 3164 by 3092 at 100% render scale. Now, the FOV on this, the field of view set at 98 horizontal, 114 vertical, and that really allows for just the best, or one of the best, right, immersions you can get for these headsets with this level of clarity. On top of that, you get the separate audio, which, as you can see, it's off the ear, and the audio quality on that, it's absolutely amazing, as well as a 6 meter cable, which has also led to improved hardware support. Now, guys, inside the box, you're going to get the VR headset, a 6 meter cable, which is absolutely amazing, two motion controllers, a DisplayPort to mini DisplayPort adapter, and USB-C to A adapter for those of you guys on laptops, as well as a power adapter. Now, guys, the first major improvement we're going to see to this headset, which was a really big deal, was the improved tracking to the controllers. They're talking about a 30% increase on the field. I guess I'm not sure if the field of view, or I guess the range in which you get the tracking, right? So if you're working below the waist or really far above your head, what you get is just a really improved experience. And to summarize it, I would say, and actually other people have said this too, it is almost as good as the Quest 2. Now, let me be clear. I don't think any solution yet is perfect, but it's really good and it's improved. In fact, I was doing a lot of contractors in VR, and just doing the running and gunning really allowed me to just get in a place where I could just reload fast, use the motions, hold the gun, reload, drop the magazine. And especially in this scenario where you're running around in that little, it's, I guess, like a kill house. You're trying to get the shot after shot after shot. And in fact, I got faster and faster and faster. I went from 60 seconds down to about 28.8 seconds at the end. And again, just the tracking was really on point, and I ran that scenario probably like 10 times in a row. Now, the other sims I got to try was VTOL VR, which is an amazing experience. It's literally just the controls alone. There's nothing else. I sit in a chair. I have room around me because you have to turn on every switch. You have to control the joystick. You have to let go of the throttle, grab everything, set up your TAD, set up the computer, lock on the aircraft, and it is an amazing experience. And these headsets, the handsets really allowed for a great, great experience. Again, another situation which I love to use as controller is in Microsoft Flight Sim 2020, you know, using the overhead panel in the Airbus or using the FS Kneeboard Pro by Christian. It's just an amazing piece of software. And as you can see, I'm just turning the knobs, clicking the different GPS, whether it's the G1000, starting up the Airbus overhead, or just interacting with anything in the cockpit. I really found no issues. So whether I'm sitting here in my sim pit, you know, using it for a flight simulator, or VTOL VR, or standing here playing Skyrim, it was an improved experience. As you reach behind your back, below the waist, it was just really, really, really good experience. And don't check your phone. That was actually my phone here. So that covers the handset controller, guys. Again, they did a really good job improving them. And actually, one of the things that they've said for these, if you do run batteries that are at 1.2 volts, you might find issues with it. It's gonna say very low batteries on them. In fact, let me see what I have. Mine are 1.5 volts, and I think the battery reads correctly. So check to see if your AA's are 1.2 volts. If not, just try to get 1.5 volts. You should have a good experience overall, but occasionally you might get reduced functionality as it kind of thinks that your battery's low when it's really not. So it'll stop the vibration motors in the controller. So it's just kind of something to keep in mind. I'll try to see if I can link some battery alternatives or the ones that I use on here, which are actually pretty good. Okay, guys, so the next thing that was really improved was the field of view, and this was accomplished not by doing anything specifically with the screens or with the Fresnel lenses, but by creating this thinner gasket, and it's actually detachable with magnets. As you can see, actually, there's another way to know if you have the G2 V2, but check this out. It splits right there, and there it is. So this is the part that detaches that really tells you, first of all, if when you're opening your box, you have a G2 V2, this is the easiest way to tell right here. And also if your cable, it's the newer cable, I'll show that here in a moment. But guys, what they've done is, I think they've actually really shaved a lot. It's really hard for me to show you because, right, the nose is in the way. But I think you can see it there, right? Look at the thinness. Look at how thin one headset is versus the other. The G2 V2 face mask brings you closer to the lenses in virtual reality, and that really does increase your field of view. Again, if you wear glasses, keep the gasket, and if you don't, or maybe if you can wear contacts, check it out. But this is a huge improvement for the field of view. It's amazing. And real fast, I don't know if HP is going to start selling this. In fact, I do have a 3D printed gasket right here, and I have one by VR Cover, which is actually pretty good. I'll leave this linked below. And this does actually improve your field of view by just a bit, because this pad is a little bit thinner, but the overall face mask itself, it's the same thickness. So I've actually shot them a message. I've also emailed HP to see if they're gonna sell this improved face mask separately. It would be really smart if either company did this, because it would be a great value for you guys. And if I get a response, I'll tweet about it, throw it on Discord, or wherever I can let you guys know that it's gonna be available. Now guys, real fast, if you're finding any value in the video, if what I'm sharing with you has been helpful, I wanna tell you, just smash that thumbs up button, leave me a comment below, give me some feedback. I really do appreciate it. It helps other people find the video, and feel free to share this with your friends. Thank you. Now guys, finally, one of the last things that was improved was the hardware support for AMD users. Now this actually also helped everyone else, even those that have Nvidia. If you were having issues as far as plugging into a USB-C port and then having, you know, connection issues, error 7-14 or different things, getting the upgraded G2 V2 cable, as I'm going to call it, really solved a lot of these issues. Now, if it's under warranty, you should be able to get it on replacement. So I'm going to leave that link below for you guys to take a look at that. And the next thing is, if you are out of warranty, it is $90. Again, that's not an affiliate link there, but I'll just leave that there for you guys. Just consider it. It might solve a lot of your issues, and a lot of people are reporting improved functionality and being able to plug it into essentially any USB port that's USB 3.0 on their computer, and that's been a really good experience. So the alternative to that, if you can't get it free, is to buy it. And finally, if you can't buy it, one solution that has helped a lot of people is getting a powered USB-C hub, which I'll show mine pictured here. In fact, I have one right there, and I have probably four of them on this because I have so many USB ports that I need to run all my hardware. It's really the best solution you guys can find to get stability in VR with the Reverb G2 V2. All right, guys, so we just answered, what are the major improvements to the G2 V2? Now, the real question is, are they worth it? You know, when you tie that into these 2160 by 2160 panels, this awesome audio solution, the fact that it's really comfortable, I don't think I've mentioned that. This is really comfortable. You get the IPD adjustment at the bottom right here, right? So the lenses actually move, as you can see. So that's excellent. It really allows you to find a good field of view. And actually, once you have the improved gasket, you don't feel like you're in a tunnel. It actually improves the FOV quite a bit. I don't know how to really put it in a number, but it's a lot better. So the question is, should you consider this headset for what you're doing? And I think absolutely. This headset sells for $600, and it will drop as low as $450. In fact, it was $450 a week ago from today. In fact, like 3 days ago, it was $450. So when you catch it on sale, $450, under $1,000, this is the best headset. Under $600, this is the best headset. So definitely consider, guys, and feel free to subscribe. Let me know if you guys have any other questions. Leave them in the comments below. But I'll have more content here, especially that AKX coming up soon. So check it out. Peace out.